Growing up in Dayton, Ohio, I often wondered why and how things happened. I remember watching television on Saturday mornings and seeing the Jetsons. Yes, I'm showing my age by talking about this television cartoon. Back then, it seemed impossible to see a flying automobile. It was unbelievable to see that. Since it was just a television cartoon, it didn't seem that can become a reality. 50 years later, it's now real, and many more vehicles like this are currently being developed. During the summer, I would be outside playing with my siblings and friends on a bright sunny day, and I would hear thunder, and I would wonder why it was happening since I didn't see any rain or lightning. It wasn't until I was in college that I realized what I was hearing. It was sonic booms from supersonic aircraft being scrambled at a Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. Those sonic booms were created by those aircraft breaking the sound barrier by flying faster than 700 miles per hour. This is a picture of an F-22 aircraft breaking the sound barrier. You can see the Mach cone created by going faster than the speed of sound. Today, NASA is on the cusp of flying a new experimental aircraft called the X-59 Low Boom Flight Demonstrator that will significantly reduce or potentially eliminate sonic booms. Some of you may know that I'm a big fan of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. They have an animated series called What If, where they let their imagination know no bounds. So this evening, I pose the following question. What if? What if I did the same with aerospace technology and allowed my imagination to ponder things that seem unachievable or unimaginable? I know it can be a little dangerous when my imagination runs away with things. NASA's Glenn Research Center has demonstrated that our imaginations can become reality. As things we thought we couldn't achieve, we made happen. At this event several years ago, a colleague showed a material that can change shapes and then return to its original form. Many people thought shape memory alloys were physically impossible, but Glenn made it possible. Now, this revolutionary material is being utilized in numerous aeronautics and space applications. Later, one of my colleagues will continue to discuss Glenn's innovative materials research. What if we continue on the path of developing revolutionary technology that changes the way we look at the world, the way we operate in the world, the way we benefit the world, through innovative breakthroughs in research and scientific discovery? This is a AA battery. What if this AA battery contained enough power to power our homes during an electrical outage? Enough power to fly an electric aircraft, or enough power to sustain a lunar base, which going through a lunar cycle of 14 days of sunlight, 14 days of night. I know that sounds far-fetched, but I challenge you to think about what has happened since the 1950s when computers were first developed. The first computer developed looked like this picture and could perform only 5,000 computational operations per second. As the uses of computers grew and technology continued to evolve, a key component to the evolution of computers and computing power was the integrated circuit, or computer chip. Integrated circuits are the brains and foundations of computing and computer systems. Dr. Gordon Moore, a scientist and a co-founder of Intel, postulated a theory that the number of transistors on an integrated circuit would double every 2 years with minimal rise, with minimal rise in cost. This theory, called Moore's Law, is the observation that the number of transistors would increase significantly over that 2 year period. The number of transistors contained on an integrated circuit have increased, and so integrated circuits have become more powerful, but smaller, as Dr. Moore projected. So this smartphone, even though it's significantly smaller, can perform 5 trillion computer operations per second, infinitely more computer power than that first computer that filled up multiple rooms that can perform only 5,000 computational operations per second. What if Glenn focused its research on developing breakthrough materials that can lead to advanced batteries and fuel cells? Breakthrough materials are critical in the development of revolutionary power and energy storage systems. By doubling or quadrupling the energy densities of advanced batteries and fuel cells through using leading-edge materials, we can approach a similar path as the integrated circuit. The energy density is defined as the amount of energy contained in a unit volume of something the size of a battery. A AA battery contains 1.5 watts and 2,500 milliamps, ampere hours. This means it can provide up to 1.5 watts of power for up to 2 hours before it needs to be replaced. If we can double or quadruple the amount of energy output yearly from the same volume contained in that battery, then we could approach something akin to what Dr. Moore projected for the integrated circuit. We don't have a name for this new theory, but I suggest we call it Shyne's Law. I'm just saying. Has a nice ring to it, Shyne's Law. Breakthroughs of this magnitude can lead to transformative missions for aeronautics and space applications. Additionally, it could have significant impact on terrestrial power systems and energy storage and help solve global power shortages. So as I think about the potential of this AA battery to power my entire home, it doesn't seem so far-fetched when you think about the other breakthroughs that Glenn has achieved through a long-term focus on revolutionary technology development. The only thing that stops us are the limits of our imaginations and our commitment to sustaining and growing Glenn's fundamental research required to make Shyne's Law a reality. So tonight and every day moving forward, I will ask the question, what if? Are we going to step up to this moment and change the future of technology for the greater good, or are we going to let this moment pass us by? A philosopher once said, look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment, would you capture it or let it slip? That's a quote from Eminem in his song, Lose Yourself, from the 8 Mile movie soundtrack. I submit that moment is now. Will we seize this opportunity or will we let it slip? If we accept this challenge, let's move Glenn forward in this mission of developing revolutionary technology, anchored by a campus with new and revitalized facilities and infrastructure, and leveraged by a new generation of engineers and scientists. Our future is waiting, and it is bright. Thank you for listening, and good evening.